Welcome to worship at First United Methodist Church in Colorado Springs, Colorado. Under the leadership of our senior pastor, Reverend Kent Ingram, our family of faith is called to be a voice of unity and inclusion in the midst of a divided world. You are invited to join us at one of our multiple locations in the heart of downtown or in Banning Lewis Ranch. Join us now as we experience the presence of Christ during worship today.
Come, listen to the story. Come, tell the story. Come, experience the story. Come, let us listen, tell, and experience the good news together. Let us pray together. God of abundance and mercy, we acknowledge your presence among us today. Open our eyes to see the path before us. Deepen our faith to walk with you upon this path. Strengthen our hearts with courage to embark on the journey. Enlarge our hearts with gratitude for your provision along the way. Teach us these things today, O God. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. In trust and confidence, let us go to the lover of our souls to admit our need and confess our sin. Let us pray. Merciful Savior, we are short-sighted and forgetful, and we are sorry. With a word, you created all that is, and your word still has power to deliver us from storms of doubt and fear. but we fail to call on you. We rely on our own resources rather than trust yours. We muddle along in weakness, forgetting how readily available to us is your strength. Deliver us, gracious God. Calm the storm within us by being our peace, and renew us in love and trust. For the sake of Christ we pray. Amen. The power that stilled the sea is the same power that defeated sin and death through life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Receive what he freely offers, forgiveness and new life. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Can you think of a time that you have been so excited that you couldn't fall asleep? Maybe it was before a big trip, or right before your birthday, or Christmas. Now, have you ever tried to sleep when there's been a big thunderstorm outside? Or maybe you've tried to sleep near a train, and it would wake you up as it would go by. Well, there's a story that we're going to talk about in Sunday school today from the book of Mark. And see, Jesus is asleep, and he's taking a nap on a boat. And he is sleeping through a huge storm. It is so scary that the disciples on the boat with him think the boat is going to crash and they're all going to drown in the ocean. And Jesus is just asleep through it all. So what do the disciples do? They decide to wake Jesus up. They say, "Hey, Jesus, Hey, Jesus, we're really scared. What do we do? So what happens is Jesus calms the storm that is so scary. The disciples are afraid for their lives. Jesus calms it, and they are safe. So what is amazing is that Jesus can calm the things in our lives that are scary, the things that make us afraid. And we can do what the disciples did, and we can say, Jesus, we need your help today. Or I need your help with this scary thing. And Jesus can calm that for you. Will you pray with me? Dear God, when we are afraid, remind us to ask Jesus for help. When we are scared of all the things that we think might harm us, teach us to imagine Jesus calming the sea. Amen.
Well, good morning and welcome to worship here at First United Methodist Church. We are grateful that you are here, whether you are here in person with us or if you are online joining us right now or sometime through the week or on television. Thank you for joining us this morning. I do believe that at some point this morning, you will get a glimpse of the sacred. You will see God right here in our midst. So thank you for being here. Make sure before you get out of here this morning that you take a moment to say hello to one another, to connect, to make sure that others know that they are part of a community and they belong here. And if you're online, if you will take a moment to check in and to say hello to those joining us on the live stream. Kent wanted you to know this morning that he is out at the Prairie campus preaching. I guess he just got done. Their service was at 10 o'clock. So it's important to him, it's important to us and our community to keep the strength of that connection alive. So he spent his morning out there. We have all sorts of our groups that are continuing to start and restart during this time. We're still working on the ability to get it out, that information out to you in a timely manner. So if you are not sure, if you were in a group, a Sunday school, a small group, before COVID, take a moment to check in with your leader to see if you guys have started again. And if you were not part of a group or you have not been part of a group here, we have groups starting. So we have sermon reflection groups that you are welcome to go and talk about the sermon and really reflect with other people how the sermon touched them. And we have contemplative worship at 5:40 on Wednesday evenings. And when you're done with that, you can go straight to Faith Academy. So there are October encounters are out. If you did not receive one in the mail, you are welcome to grab one from the Hospitality Center this morning. October 30th is the UMW Bazaar, and the bazaar is right below us here in Fellowship Hall, and they will have quilts and table runners and crafts and food, and of course, the jewelry table that has new and used jewelry, which is so fun. Take your time there, of course. They are still looking for donations for new or nearly new items. So connect with a lady from the United Methodist Women to figure out where to bring those items. And all the funds that they make through that event are given to Methodist missions. Next month is the first Sunday of the month, so it is that Sunday that we bring in food to give to people that need a meal. So if you are at the store sometime this week, don't forget to grab an extra box or an extra can of what you're getting and drop it in one of the boxes that are by the doors on your way in. And of course, the big thing that's happening, what we are pouring ourselves into during this time, is the 150th celebration. This church is 150 years old. We have seen so much, gone through so much. We are digging through the archives and pulling up story after story and old pictures and bulletins, and we are excited about this celebration. The celebration, the anniversary kickoff, is October 17th. So we will have a big worship service, and then that evening at 5, we will have a meal together at the Antlers Hotel, a banquet. So we are excited about that, and we would love to know if you're going to join us. So FUMC-CS.org/150, and you will find a place to reserve your spot and to drop a donation if you would like to do that. We hope to see you there. Keep an eye out for other news and information as it comes out on the website and in the encounter. As always, we take a moment to return to worship and worship by giving back. God has given us so much. We have noticed a God in our midst and have so much to be thankful for. So we take this moment to give back. You can give through online giving, by texting to give, or if you're here in person, you can give in the offering baskets that are by each door on your way out. This congregation has continued to be such an amazingly faithful congregation through this time. So we are grateful, and we pray that God takes every single gift of our gifts, our talents, our time, and blesses them, that all in this world might know the depth of God's love. Amen.
us join together in affirming our faith. I believe in God the Father, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Seated. Hear these words from the book of Psalms. The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The decrees of the Lord are sure, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, even much fine gold, sweeter also than honey and drippings of the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is your servant warned. In keeping them, there is great reward. but who can detect their errors? Clear me from hidden faults. Keep back your servant also from the insolent. Do not let them have dominion over me. Then I shall be blameless and innocent of great transgression. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
I invite you to pray with me now. Good morning, Creator of all. With love, you bring us to this moment, this very day, still creating a universe we find so mysterious and beautiful. If we stop enough to consider it all, how mysterious and beautiful it is. Thank you for bringing us together, God, this morning. We turn our faces back towards your presence now. We pause, set aside our everyday lives to return to you, our foundation, our gracious, nourishing root, our all. Help us to breathe deep your wisdom and guidance this day, O God. Brother Christ, you walk with us. You show us the way of forgiveness and faith. Come now again to our side. We need your healing and supporting intervention into our many relationships with our families, with our colleagues, with ourselves, our church and world. When we decide to so often just go it on our own without a thought of asking your guidance, how do you have so much patience with us? It happens all the time, but here you are once again, shepherding us with your smile, your guidance, shepherding us, your flock, and never giving up on us. Spirit of God, stir up in us the healing and the new energy for the sake of your loving kingdoms unfolding now, right here in this space and out beyond these walls. Stir up healing. We lift to you in this moment of silence the prayers of each of our hearts. So please, God, hear our prayers. And God, hear us now as we pray together the prayer that your Son Jesus invited us to pray in saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Oh God, open us up. Open our eyes that we might see. Open our ears that we might hear. God, open our hearts that we might feel. And then, oh God, open our hands that we might serve you and your love. Amen. Do you find yourself longing for what used to be? Do you find yourself longing for that time when you could drive your car into a parking lot, park, get out, walk into a building? Do you long for a time when you could get out of your car and walk to the building without stopping and saying, oops, I forgot my mask again, returning to your car for your mask again, finally getting up to the doors and having to stop and read the windows and the walls to see if there's any sign about masks or no masks? Do you miss the days when you could just walk in and not have to check out the room to see how many are wearing masks and how many are not? Do you find yourself longing for that time when you could go walk into a restaurant and sit at your favorite table and chat with your favorite waitress as she checks in with you and asks about your kids or grandkids by name and just brings you your favorite meal without even having to ask? Does walking into restaurants and finding your favorite table closed down, does it make you long for what used to be? Walking into restaurants and finding that your favorite waitress has moved on and the meal that you always ordered is no longer available, do you find yourself longing for what used to be, for the people in your life that you just assumed would always be there? Do you find yourself longing for predictability and normalcy and routines? 18 months ago, we all left home. And maybe you define home as that place that feels safe, that you can lean in because you are comfortable. The around you is predictable and safe, and the routines keep you going through your day. But we, 18 months ago, left home. But it is not the first time that this church has left home. I know it kind of goes without saying, and I don't really need to point this out, but this beautiful sanctuary that we are sitting in today, this is not 150 years old. 150 years ago, the story goes, we began as a Sunday school in a home, and a year later, we moved into our very first sanctuary, and a decade later, our second. 20 years after that, our third. 50 years later, we moved into this building. Now, it is really easy to hear the dates, the addresses, the description of the sanctuaries that we used to call home, and forget the people and their stories. They were leaving their church home. They were leaving behind the familiar pew that they sat in for years, sometimes for their entire lives. They were leaving behind memories and stories, that wall that they had painted or that nail that they had hammered into that wood, leaving behind memories of weddings and funerals, laughter and joy, new beginnings and long goodbyes. Of course, that is moving on for bigger and better things, dreaming of something new, a bigger, better future. It became with hope and joy and happiness. But there was still longing for what used to be. There was still grief at leaving home. And of course, not every time we have left home has it been planned. Has it not been to follow dreams? This congregation has left home many times in its 150 years. During world wars, during planes flying into buildings, school shootings, movements and protests, this community found itself far from home when it suddenly and unexpectedly in the 60s lost a long time beloved pastor. And of course, we have left home during worldwide pandemics. It is not often that preachers can sit down in their study and think about their congregation and the thoughts and the prayers and the fears that the congregation brings and know that they all bring with them something similar. But for the last 18 months, we are all carrying a sense of grief, fear. Our thoughts and prayers rest in the same place. So I'm doing a sermon series called Welcome Home at Heartstrings. And we've all left home. We've all left this space and carry with us this deep grief. And we're trying to return to something close to normal, something close to home. If you step back and you look at our world, or you look back into your week and your life and your interactions, you will see the grief. You will see the grief coming out in sadness, yes, in exhaustion, of course, but you'll also see moments of frustration and irritation and it just being too much. Do you feel yourself longing for how things used to be? Do you find yourself in storms? In the storms that are surrounding us, do you feel like a ship on a stormy sea being blown to and fro, like you're not sure about the ground under you? It's just not solid enough. Do you long for the days when you could wake up in the morning and you just knew what to expect and what the world would be like that day? Well, the disciples knew what it was to be far from home. I just skipped a whole bunch, I'm sorry. So this week I was at a restaurant, I went into a restaurant that I had gone into so many times. Time after time since they reopened, and I went and sat down and I went to order my favorite meal. It was so good. It's spicy corn nuggets with extra ranch. It was just amazing, and I was so looking forward to it. And I sat down, and of course, assuming that it was still there and still on the menu, and of course, you know what's coming. It was not. I was so disappointed. But they explained that the suppliers were having issues getting their systems back up and running. The truck companies that would bring the food to the restaurant were struggling getting back up and running. And the restaurant itself, although it was open and it was running and they had customers, just not quite as many as they used to have yet. So they had to decide what to keep on the menu and what to let go of. It feels like the really big things that are happening right now should be the things that really weigh us down, but I have to admit, it's often for me the thousand little tiny ways that I'm uncertain, unsure, that I assume things would be like they used to be, and they just aren't anymore. I really do find myself longing for home, longing for what used to be, longing for certainty and safety and predictability and the routines that used to hold me up. And of course, the disciples were far from home. They knew the feeling of longing from home. They knew the feeling of being away from home. Jesus, just one day walking down the beach, calls to them, says, "Come, follow me." And there they are in the normal routines of their day, and they immediately drop their nets. They drop their routines, their safety, the comfort of home, and they follow Jesus. And of course they saw amazing, amazing things. They saw miracles. They made friendships. But they also experienced storms. They experienced storms away from home. Hear these words from the Gospel of Mark. "On that day, when evening had come, Jesus said to them, 'Let us go across to the other side.' And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him up and said to him, 'Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?' He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, 'Peace, be still.' Then the wind ceased, and there was a dead calm. He said to them, 'Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?'" May God bless the reading, hearing, and understanding of this word. The disciples in the Gospel of Mark never really understood who Jesus was. They did not understand him to be the Messiah. And when they did guess the Messiah, they got who the Messiah was and the work the Messiah was going to do in the world. They got it completely wrong. They lived with Jesus for years. They shared meals with him. They shared stories of their life. They heard stories of Jesus' life. Together, they traveled. The disciples walked for Jesus for years and saw firsthand miracle after miracle, and still missed Jesus in their midst, maybe especially during the storms. I guess that gives me a little permission I guess it means that it's not very surprising when we miss Jesus in our midst, maybe especially during the storms. But this storm in the Gospel of Mark, it reminds us that Jesus is in our midst, that God's love is bigger than the storms we are weathering, that God's healing presence is right there in our midst. This text reminds us that God's strength and power is greater than any storm we will encounter. You know, it was just a little thing earlier this year. I'm sure you would think it was just a little thing, and to me it felt big, but you know, I'm sure just in the long stream of moments of life, I'm gonna forget it. I won't even remember that it happened. But earlier this year, I'm planning this big family event. And I was so excited for it, and I really, really wanted to pull it off, and I wanted to do this so well. You know exactly what I ran into. Every single thing that used to be easy 2 years ago somehow was way harder than it should be. There is not one little detail that just fell into place. Of course, there's no spicy corn nuggets. Of course, you cannot count on an airplane taking off on time or landing on time, much less taking off at all. And those invitations that you want to get there on time for the party, yeah, don't count on that. And the question of masks, no masks, Zoom, in person, yeah, don't even go there or try to plan that. There really is no telling. Needless to say, as I'm planning this event, I am so frustrated. As hard as I tried, I just could not pull it together. And the more I tried, the more frustrated I got, until my sister decided to, you know, she's looking at the event and she knows how important it is. And she pointed out some of the pieces that I wasn't quite getting, the pieces that I was missing. And you know exactly what I did. My frustration and irritation boiling over till I let her know in no uncertain terms how hard I was trying and how unfair it was for her to keep pushing me to get the family event done. And then there's this moment in the middle of our conversation. She looked at me. I looked at her looking at me. We named the frustration. We put before us and acknowledged that uncontainable longing for home. We named this deep grief that is in the air we breathe from the time we wake up in the morning until the time we go to bed at night. I remember standing there. It felt like this moment when the storms ceased, when a calm settled down upon us. I could almost hear Jesus whisper, "Peace, be still." Why are you afraid? Do you not still have faith? Will you please stand as we sing our final hymn together? Now go forth in peace. May the grace of Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit go with you all now and forever. Amen.
Lift up your voices for Lord. that's an old Hank Williams song, which is nice. He wrote a lot of great gospel. All right, I'm going to take...